and now I've gone away. There's no one left to stay. The Maryville Saints Hockey Network welcomes you to the following presentation of the American Collegiate Hockey Association.
Welcome back to the Maryville University Hockey Center. I'm Chuck Krause, joined by nobody. It's me tonight, folks. If you're here after watching the D1 hockey game, welcome back. If you're here strictly for D2, welcome to the game. Maryville Saints D2 team coach, head coach Aaron Romerill here joined. Are they bringing in the SLU Billikens? Last night, Maryville and SLU played one another. Maryville comes out with the loss. SLU wins 4-2. And, it's not quite the game that Coach Romero really wanted for his team. We're here. It's Maryville University Hockey Center. The national anthem's going off. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll do a little bit of a rundown, and we'll have the puck drop for you.
Number ones will cook you with that first step.
Your L, sir. Compliments of the chef.
Number tens, more gold than Midas.
Midas who?
Twenty-fours will live in your head.
I'm home.
33s put in so many hours, they'll be the first to defeat Father.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back into the Maryville University Hockey Center. This is the Maryville Saints Hockey Network. I'm Chuck Krause. We're bringing you D2 Saints and the SLU Billikens. Let's start off with our starting lines for tonight. For your Maryville Saints, in goal, we've got Max Gaudette. on defense. Johnny Verdue and Spencer Turner. And up on that forward line, we have Riley Just, Matt Simoncelli, and Matt Birkemeyer. Billikens get it up. Number four shot. Save. Easy save by Max Gaudette. As Slew starting it off early here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. Shot on was William Jackson. Puck one back around the corner. Matt Birkemeyer over. Goes back into Slew's zone. Puck covered up. Faceoff in the offensive zone for the Maryville Saints. Maryville and Slew met last night. Slew came out with the win 4-2. Jens Juliusson in for the faceoff for Maryville Saints. Puck into the corner. Jens fighting for it. Back in the middle. Shot. Goal! Saints! Jens Juliusson wins it from behind, puts it into the middle, and that's a goal for Spencer Barlow. Fast start here for Maryville. Their second shot on goal, and they're up 1-0. 19:23 left in the period. And a good start. Maryville wanting to start it off early, and they certainly do. We take a minute as one of the linesmen gets ready. Guess he wasn't aware the game was at 7 o'clock tonight. Or 8 o'clock, I'm sorry. Big faceoff win by Jens Juliusson. Gets it down in the corner. And Spencer Barlow buries it for the Maryville Saints, putting them up 1-0. Alex Keller, Jens Juliusson, and Spencer Barlow with the puck into the Billiken zone. Puts it down. Keller chases it. Up in the middle, just past Jens Juliusson. Thomas Fitt puts it back into the zone. Good pressure by Maryville. Spencer Barlow keeps it into the zone. Spencer Barlow up, shot! Oh, what a save. Unable to get the rebound is Jens Juliusson, as Spencer Barlow is able to put a nice shot on goal. Alex Keller into the neutral zone, passes it over to Barlow. Behind the net, Jens Juliusson. Kemmer with the shot, save. Puck down to the point. Feltz has it under the far boards, puts behind the goal. Juliusson chases it as Phil Kemmer keeps it in on the blue line. Keller to Juliusson. Oh, big keep by Phil Kemmer as he puts it in behind. Slew up to the neutral zone with speed. That's number 16, Tarek Bagg. Juliusson with the pass, able to get it out of the zone. That's Michael Lane, oversteps the puck. Phil Kemmer back behind Max Gaudette. Troy Hafner with the puck, passes it over. Michael Lane into the zone. Breaks in the middle, pass, oh, just over the goal. Billiken's able to get it back into the neutral zone, into Maryville's zone, back behind Max Gaudette. Ryan Gridley's there, and the puck goes out of play. So a few chances for the Maryville Saints. Starting it off early, four shots on goal for Maryville. One shot on goal for the Billikens. It's a good start as Maryville came out with the loss last night. Michael Callahan in for the faceoff from Slew, loses it. Callahan with the puck. Puts it in, Spencer Turner behind. Good stop, Spencer Turner behind Max Gaudette. Hooked a little bit, 20, okay. We'll take that. Spencer Turnick did not see the puck come. A big hit on the far side. Puck cleared down, looking for an ice, no ice, as Johnny Verdu has the puck. Kept in by Slew, put it in behind Max Gaudette. Spencer Turner there, took his man, and he comes out with it. Joey Sabatino down in the corner, takes out his man. Thomas Fitt back to Sabatino, in front shot, oh! What a save by the Slew goaltender. Back in front. Scrum down in the side. Not sure where it went. St. Louis University goalie was able to cover it up. Faceoff in the Billiken zone. So faceoff to the right. Matt Simoncelli in for the faceoff for the Saints. Puck behind the goal. Billiken's up into the neutral zone, put it in the Maryville zone. No icing on the play. Oh, big hit from behind by Matt Simoncelli. And that's going to be a penalty on number 19, Matt Simoncelli, for a cross check. As the Slew player was facing the boards here, and you could see his face right against the glass. So Slew will go on the power play. Augustine Heidhouse in for the draw, loses it, and Maryville's able to clear it out. On the forecheck is Spencer Barlow. Slew behind their own goal. They set it up as they exit their zone. Spencer Turner back. Goes to clear it. Keep in by Heidhouse. And he's tripped up. Maryville's going to go on a two-man advantage to kill off. Right now it's a 6-on-4 as it's a delay penalty. Maryville touches it. Johnny Verdu behind his goal. So Spencer Turner is going to go off. 2 minutes for tripping. And for minute 19, Slew's going to have a two-man advantage. What an opportunity for them to tie the game up here. 15-11 left in the period. Shots are 5-3 in favor of Maryville. Michael Callahan in for the faceoff for Slew. Wins it. Back to the defense. Far side, back to the D, takes a shot, and it's a goal. Michael Callahan from the middle, two scores on the two-man advantage. Billiken's able to tie the game up 1-1 on their fourth shot of the game. Not much you can do with the two-man advantage. Callahan was wide open. Couple of guys in front of Max Gaudette. 1-1 is the score. And Billikens are still going to have a power play for minute 48. Into the zone, Jeffrey Au. Maryville able to clear the zone. Defender's able, Michael Callahan gets the shot. Michael Callahan in front. Back to the defense as Slew. Good block in front by Feltz. From one D to the other. Back behind the net is Slew. Phil Keimer there taking out his man. And the puck is cleared by Tim Rye. Both teams for the wholesale change. Jens Juliason out high for the Maryville Saints with Spencer Barlow. Slew gains the zone. Far side. Beats his man. Shot. Goal! St. Louis University makes it a 2-1 game on the power play with their fifth shot on goal. That is number 7, Michael Jonell, with the goal. 2-1 Billikens, 13:42 left in the game. I'm sorry, left in the period. That'd be quite a quick game. And that's why you got to stay out of the box, folks. Just like that, 2-1 answered for the Billikens. Michael Lane clears it down. Troy Hafner chases. Michael Lane in, down low, puts it in front. Slew's able to kick it out. Steal. Good defense by Billikens as down low is Troy Hafner. Wrap around. Oh, good save by Slew's goaltender. Travis Herrick up, passes over. Good defense by number 73, Thomas Vitt. Slew keeps it in the zone. Vitt on the far side, takes a couple hits. A slash or two, if you will. Michael Lane takes his man. Vitt up. Hafner to Juliason. Maryville's offside. Troy Hafner, Jens Juliason going off for the change. We got Spencer Barlow coming back out. Spencer Turner, Johnny Verdu. Jens wins it all the way back to the right of Max Gaudet. He's going to play it. Over to Spencer Barlow. Barlow back to Turner. Turner misses it. Jens Juliason skates. Pass over to Alex Keller. No ice. In the middle. Alex Keller. Jens Juliason. Oh, just over the goal. It was tipped. Hit behind the net by Spencer Barlow. Alex Keller. Taking his man, Jens Juliason, into the corner, as well as Barlow and Keller. They're all right there. Spencer Turner back at his own point. Back behind the net. Jens Juliason is there. Passes in the middle. Shot. Oh, just wide of the goal. Johnny Verdu able to keep it in. Back to Spencer Turner. Shot. Blocked in front. Another shot blocked in front. Slew going for the hoister. They keep it in. Johnny Verdu keeps it in. Alex Keller behind Slew's goal. Beats his man. Jens Juliason out there to help. Passes it into the middle. Johnny Verdu keeps it in again. Slew unable to get it. Spencer Turner shot on goal tipped. Just hits the side of the goal. Johnny Verdu with the puck. Down low to Alex Keller. Alex Keller gets his pocket picked, and the puck is out. Tim Rye back into his zone. Behind Max Gaudet, up to Tim Rye. Phil Kemmer clears it out. Into the neutral zone. Ryan Gridley chases the puck back into his zone. He's chased by two Billikens. Joey Sabatino there. Ryan Gridley skates the puck into the zone, chases it. Ryan Gridley back, Tim Rye behind the goal. Feeds it in front. Pass off to nowhere. Ryan Gridley had no one. Slew up, takes a shot. Save Max Gaudet, right into the middle. Slew is able to keep it in the zone. Joey Sabatino clears it out, looking for Riley Just, as he's the only one in the zone. Stretch pass. Phil Kemmer breaks it up. Fans calling for a call, but no call on the play. Raleigh Just to Matt Simoncelli. Mishandles it, and Slew's able to get it out. Shot on by Augustine Heidhaus goes wide. And Feltz. Stick gets a stick all over him, and there's going to be a penalty on the play. Max Gaudette goes to the bench. And the Maryville Saints are going to go on a power play. As Justin Feltz, the defender, skating out of his zone, took about four or five sticks. And Joey Gregluski is going to go to the box for the Slew Billikens. Jens Juliusson, Spencer Turner, Spencer Barlow, Matt Simoncelli for the power play. Juliusson shot blocked in front. Slew able to clear it out as Jeffrey Au. Big hit by Spencer Turner. Jens Juliusson behind his home goal. Taken down, no call. Matt Simoncelli back to Jens Juliusson. Juliusson exits his zone. Up to Matt Simoncelli into the Slew zone. Gets a shot, easy glove. We're going to go to the left of the Slew goaltender for a faceoff. Alex Keller going to take the faceoff for the Maryville Saints against Michael Callahan. Able to clear it out. Phil Kemmer gets it in the neutral zone. Up to Michael Lane. Lane in with Berkmeyer. Lane makes a move. And the Billikens able to clear it out. Max Gaudette plays it down. Phil Kemmer behind his own goal to play it. Alex Keller, Justin Feltz. Feltz up the far side. Up to Berkmeyer. Berkmeyer takes a knee in the neutral zone. He gets up. Feltz back on the point. Loses it. Phil Kemmer's got it on the point. Over to Keller. Feltz, shot, just wide. Puck is covered up. 44 seconds left to go in the Slew penalty. 8 minutes on the dot left in the first period. Shots are all tied up, 8-8. 2-1, Slew leads. Maryville still on the power play. Puck one back to Spencer Turner. Over his stick, Spencer Turner, the speedy Spencer Turner in his own zone. He's going to take it himself. Through the neutral zone, still keeps it into the offensive zone. Puck lost. Spencer Barlow in his own zone, looking for a man. Over to Spencer Turner. Turner crosses the blue line into Slew zone. Matt Simoncelli, far side. Over to Jens Juliusson, shot, tip, goal! Power play goal for the Maryville Saints. Jens Juliusson feeds it in front. And what a beautiful tip. Maryville Saints take the power play, and they tie it up on the ninth shot of the game. 6 seconds left in the power play. It's a 2-2 game. Puck back behind Max Gaudette. Phil Kemmer there. He's got two Billikens on him. Tim Rye there helping out. Tim Rye comes out with it. Back in the Billiken zone, Phil Kemmer there. He's pressured by Nolan Meyer. Puck back into the neutral zone. Over to Meyer. Meyer can't handle it. Phil Kemmer in behind Maryville's goal. Looks for a man, gets one on the far side. Slew's able to break it up back into Maryville zone. Phil Kemmer to the near side. Tim Rye's there, but it goes just past him. Once again, Phil Kemmer over to the far side. Maryville's able to clear it out. Tim Rye on the chase. Slew able to clear it out. Can't get a hold on it as Travis Herrick. And it just, good defense by number 24. A lot of names not on my roster sheet tonight, folks. You never know what's going to happen with the ACHA team, so bear with me. Puck back down into the Billiken zone. Michael Lane's there. Puck shot. Just wide of the goal as Troy Hafner was right there on the doorstep. Michael Lane and Troy Hafner battling down low. Out to the point. Shot. Save. Just passed as it's tipped. Michael Jonell up on the play. Good defense. Takes out his man. Feltz is there. Michael Lane with the puck by himself. One on three. He gets passed. Good defense. Puck behind the net. Troy Hafner's with him. And Slew's able to clear it out. Johnny Verdu's there. Pass over to Simon Selle. Simon Selle far side. Gets it up to Troy Hafner. Troy Hafner by himself. And Slew's able to clear it. Johnny Verdu's there. Matt Simon Selle clears it out into the neutral zone. Nothing there. Verdu with the play. And Slew's able to put it right back to the left of Max Gaudette. Spencer Turner's there. Big hit by Spencer Turner. He takes out his man. That's Michael Callahan. Johnny Verdu with the puck. Gets in by himself. Takes a shot. Steered to the side. Riley Just is there. Simon Selle, he gets beat. Johnny Verdu puts it just right back on to goal. Puck behind the Slew goaltender. Riley Just, Matt Simon Selle, couple big hits. Ryan Gridley's there for Maryville Saints coming out of his zone. Matt Birkenmeyer unable to clear it. Riley Just in on his far side. Puck goes straight up and straight down. Phil Kemmer for the Saints. Over to Ryan Gridley. Ryan Gridley over to Riley Just, who just clears it into Slew zone, and that's going to be an icing. So 3:10 left in this first period. 2-2 is the score. 11 shots on goal for Maryville, 9 for Slew. 4 goals already in this first period. Both teams looking to take the W. Phil Kemmer with the puck behind his net. Over to Riley Just on the far side. Able to clear it out. Jens Juliason is there. Over the blue line. Takes a shot. Just over the net. Birkenmeyer's there. Jens Juliason. Puck out of the zone all the way back to the Maryville defensive zone. Phil Kemmer is there. Same side to Birkenmeyer. Tipped up to Jens Juliason by himself. And a good defense. Jens Juliason back to the point. Shot. Tip. Just a good save. Alex Keller's there for the rebound. And the puck's past Phil Kemmer for an icing. All the way back down to the Billikens defensive zone. Spencer Barlow, Jens Juliason, Alex Keller, Thomas Vitt, and Justin Feltz. Alex Keller behind the net, up in front, just wide, Spencer Barlow. Billiken's able to clear Justin Feltz into the neutral zone, over to Alex Keller, over the blue line. He's got Jens Juliason, takes it wide. behind the net. Alex Keller still with the puck. Back to Vitt. Vitt over to Jens Juliasson. Juliasson into the middle. Alex Keller behind the net to Jens Juliasson. Spencer Barlow. Oh, and what a save. They're going for it, and it's a goal! Spencer Barlow with the goal, picking up the trash. It is a 3-2 game, Maryville, with their 12th shot on goal, is a goal. Spencer Barlow down low, picking it up. As it appeared, the Billikens goalie had it covered, but he did not, and Spencer Barlow was there to pick it up. 3-2, Maryville. Michael Jill now on the far side. Tim Rise there. Johnny Verdu behind his net. Keeps it onto the side. Spencer Turner into the middle. Joey Sabatino down in the corner. Spencer Turner there, gets it, Sabatino. In the neutral zone is Johnny Verdu, puts it back into the Billiken zone. Sabatino is there. Slew's able to clear it out. Johnny Verdu racing for it. Number nine, here we go. What a save, Max Gaudette. As Joey Grigluski was in all by himself. 1 minute to go in the period. Shot on, save Max Gaudette. Another save Max Gaudette, and it's wide. He's swimming in there, folks. And the puck is cleared out. 40 seconds to go in the period. Grigluski in again. Shot, save Max Gaudette. Jens Juliasson with it. Over to Spencer Barlow. Barlow gets tripped up, no call. Keller gets it by himself. Jens Juliasson's there. Oh, just over the goal. And then Jens Juliasson is pushed right into the goal. It comes off the moorings. Back-to-back action here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. 17.7 seconds to go in the first period. Maryville up 3-2. Faceoff's going to be to the left of the Billikens. Goaltender taken by number 27, Jens Juliasson. He wins it back to Keller. Keller back to Phil Kemmer. Kemmer into the far corner. Keller's there. Juliasson is there. Puck is kept in. A Slew player is down. I'm not sure if he felt that. 1-2-1. And that's a period. Shots are even, 12-12. Maryville Saints take the late lead in the first period, 3-2. Goal by Spencer Barlow to put them up. An exciting game just like we expected as Maryville and Slew faced one another last night. We're gonna go ahead and take a break, break it down for you, 3-2. In favor of Maryville here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. You're watching Maryville Saints Hockey on the Maryville Saints Hockey Network.
vedo il fondo. Non lo reggo un altro secondo.
Gambe a pezzi e manca tanto. Basta, mollo, non me la sento.
Non ho fiato e sono lento. Non giocherò mai, zero talento.
Pedalate pesanti, non ho più spinta. Ma quale cima, non basta la grinta.
Non prendo una palla, sono sfinita. Male oggi, penso in partita.
CCM One Piece boot.
The CCM One Piece boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid.
Anyone could be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that One Piece boot, you duster.
A dream.
Go back to sleep.
Hi, I'm Keegan with How Ice Hockey Tape, and today we're going to be talking about using a skate stone. Skate stones are a pregame or an in-game tool to help sharpen dull or nicked blades that have lost their edge. When you're using a skate stone, it's extremely important to remember never to touch the bottom of the blade. It's only to be used on the sides of the blade. So what you're going to do, take your skate stone, and you're just going to make a couple passes along the side of the blade, not using too much pressure or too little pressure, just making a couple passes on both sides. Using the skate stone is just a temporary fix. It's not a good substitute for getting your skate sharpened. Make sure to get your skates to your trusted skate shop for the perfect cut.
In today's sports world, high-quality video and accurate data are key elements for improving team results, player development, and fan engagement. Pixelot, the world's leading AI-automated sports production company, provides an end-to-end video and data solution for fans, players, and coaches. Pixelot systems are installed around the world and produce thousands of live matches every day with customized live graphics, ads, color commentary, and play-by-play.
Left wing feed, boom.
At the end of the game, our AI generates highlight reel 100% automatically. Analysts and the coaching staff get video breakdowns and stats from VidSwap, Pixelot's video analysis platform. Each game captured is automatically broken down by sports professionals on a video editing platform for in-depth analysis. The real-time game breakdowns from live video and official data include shot charts, heat maps, and detailed game, team, and player stats. The platform offers a variety of editing and self-coding tools so you can easily review plays and coach your team better both during and after the game. This all-in-one cost-effective solution also allows you to telestrate, tag, and add notes to each move, and watch your upcoming opponent's matches on the video exchange platform. Pixelot produces and analyzes thousands of games every single day from over 130 leagues and tournaments around the globe. Join the AI revolution in sports.
mi brucia tutto. Non vedo il fondo, non lo reggo un altro secondo.
Gambe a pezzi e manca tanto. Basta, mollo, non me la sento.
Non ho fiato e sono lento. Non giocherò mai, zero talento.
Pedalate pesanti, non ho più spinta. Ma quale cima, non basta la grinta.
Non prendo una palla, sono sfinita. Male oggi, penso in partita.
CCM One Piece boot.
The CCM One Piece boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that One Piece boot, you duster.
I'm Keegan with How Ice Hockey Tape, and today we're going to be talking about using a skate stone. Skate stones are a pregame or an in-game tool to help sharpen dull or nicked blades that have lost their edge. When you're using a skate stone, it's extremely important to remember never to touch the bottom of the blade. It's only to be used on the sides of the blade. So what you're going to do, take your skate stone, and you're just going to make a couple passes along the side of the blade, not using too much pressure or too little pressure, just making a couple passes on both sides. Using a skate stone is just a temporary fix. It's not a good substitute for getting your skate sharpened. Make sure to get your skates to your trusted skate shop for the perfect cut.
In today's sports world, high quality video and accurate data are key elements for improving team results, player development, and fan engagement. Pixalot, the world's leading AI automated sports production company, provides an end-to-end video and data solution for fans, players, and coaches. Pixalot systems are installed around the world and produce thousands of live matches every day with customized live graphics, ads, color commentary, and play-by-play.
Left wing feed goes.
At the end of the game, our AI generates highlight reel 100% automatically. Analysts and the coaching staff get video breakdowns and stats from VidSwap, Pixalot's video analysis platform. Each game captured is automatically broken down by sports professionals on a video editing platform for in-depth analysis. The real-time game breakdowns from live video and official data include shot charts, heat maps, and detailed game, team, and player stats. The platform offers a variety of editing and self-coding tools so you can easily review plays and coach your team better both during and after the game. This all-in-one cost-effective solution also allows you to telestrate, tag, and add notes to each move and watch your upcoming opponent's matches on the video exchange platform. Pixalot produces and analyzes thousands of games every single day from over 130 leagues and tournaments around the globe. Join the AI revolution in sports.
tutto. Non vedo il fondo, non lo reggo un altro secondo.
Gambe a pezzi e manca tanto. Basta, mollo, non me la sento.
Non ho fiato e sono lento. Non giocherò mai, zero talento.
Pedalate pesanti, non ho più spinta. Ma quale cima, non basta la grinta.
Non prendo una palla, sono sfinita. Male oggi, penso in partita.
CCM One Piece boot.
The CCM One Piece boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid. Anyone could be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that One Piece boot, you duster.
Hi, I'm Keegan with How Ice Hockey Tape, and today we're going to be talking about using a skate stone. Skate stones are a pregame or an in-game tool to help sharpen dull or nicked blades that have lost their edge. When you're using a skate stone, it's extremely important to remember never to touch the bottom of the blade. It's only to be used on the sides of the blade. So what you're going to do, take your skate stone, and you're just going to make a couple passes along the side of the blade, not using too much pressure or too little pressure, just making a couple passes on both sides. Using a skate stone is just a temporary fix. It's not a good substitute for getting your skate sharpened. Make sure to get your skates to your trusted skate shop for the perfect cut.
In today's sports world, high quality video and accurate data are key elements for improving team results, player development, and fan engagement. Pixalot, the world's leading AI automated sports production company, provides an end-to-end video and data solution for fans, players, and coaches. Pixalot systems are installed around the world and produce thousands of live matches every day with customized live graphics, ads, color commentary, and play-by-play.
Left wing feed goes.
At the end of the game, our AI generates highlight reel 100% automatically. Analysts and the coaching staff get video breakdowns and stats from VidSwap, Pixalot's video analysis platform. Each game captured is automatically broken down by sports professionals on a video editing platform for in-depth analysis. The real-time game breakdowns from live video and official data include shot charts, heat maps, and detailed game, team, and player stats. The platform offers a variety of editing and self-coding tools so you can easily review plays and coach your team better both during and after the game. This all-in-one cost-effective solution also allows you to telestrate, tag, and add notes to each move and watch your upcoming opponent's matches on the video exchange platform. Pixalot produces and analyzes thousands of games every single day from over 130 leagues and tournaments around the globe. Join the AI revolution in sports.
All right, second period at the Maryville University Hockey Center. You're watching Maryville Saints Hockey Network. As the Maryville Saints welcome in the SLU Billikens second period of play. Pardon me. Spencer Turner up to Alex Keller. Unable to clear, SLU able to keep it. Johnny Verdu up behind the net. Kept in by SLU, shot just wide of Carson Zadina. Actually, folks, not Max Gaudette tonight. Johnny Verdu behind his own goal. Able to be kept in. Big hit, Spencer Barlow. Spencer Turner gets a puck, clears it out. But able to be put right in back behind Zadina. Over to Alex Keller. Keller grabs it, clears it out. Too far for Jens Juliasson. And that's an icing on the play. So 3-2 to start this second period in favor of the Maryville Saints. Shots all tied up, 12-12. And the puck's faceoff is going to be to the right of Carson Zadina. Jens Juliasson's going to take it against, well, it says Patrick Waterman, but he's a goalie, so he did not take that faceoff. Shot wide. On the near side, Sloop gets it. Shot, oh, blocked by Johnny Verdu. Jens Juliasson takes out his man. Verdu clears it for another icing call. As Maryville Saints can't really find a way to clear it out of their zone. So all they can do right now is ice the puck. Work with me, folks. We've got a lot of different numbers and different names on both the rosters. So, hey, we'll make way with what we have. Faceoff won by Jens Juliasson. Johnny Verdu over to Alex Keller on the near side. Puck cleared Broadway back down to Carson Zadina. Spencer Turner there able to clear it out of his zone back into the neutral zone and cleared in to Maryville zone. Alex Keller there on the near side. Johnny Verdu with him into the neutral zone. Joey Gregulski able to clear it in, but that's going to be an icing as Ryan Gridley is back for the puck. And the faceoff finally comes down to the Billikens zone as Maryville was just icing it the first couple minutes of the second. Now it's the Billikens' turn. Alex Chiodini loses the draw in behind to Michael Lane. Michael Lane over on the far side into the front. Chiodini there but unable to get a shot. Gridley back as the puck's to the left of Zadina. Phil Kemmer, errant pass, he gets it back. Able to clear it up to Chiodini into the zone. Michael Lane into the corner. Wins that, Chiodini, puck squirts out. And it's covered up by the Billikens goaltender. Neither team able to really get anything going so far, but it's early in the second. 13 shots apiece, 3-2 Maryville Saints, 17:33 left. Chiodini wins the faceoff. Michael Lane up. Puck overshot just wide by Troy Hafner. Chiodini pushes it behind. Michael Lane clears it in front. Troy Hafner, big hit. Gridley up to the neutral zone, intercepted. Michael Lane grabs it. Up to Troy Hafner by himself. Lane grabs it, coming behind him. A scrum in front. Three players down. And Peter Rubis able to clear it out. Back behind Carson Zadina, he clears it up. Chiodini's there. Troy Hafner up at the blue line, puts it into the Billiken zone. He keeps it. Gridley keeps it in. Maryville going for a wholesale change. Matt Simoncelli on the rush. Up through the neutral zone, into, oh, good defense, Ryan Gridley. Justin Feltz behind his own goal. Over to Riley Just. Just over to Gridley, Gridley to Simoncelli. Simoncelli back over to Just, into the zone. Matt Berkmeyer up by himself, just wide of the goal. Matt Simoncelli behind Billiken's goal. Raleigh Just there, over to Matt Berkmeyer. Berkmeyer to Feltz, shot just wide. Goes between the legs of Matt Simoncelli. Justin Feltz all the way up to Matt Simoncelli. It goes behind the Sloop goaltender. Raleigh Just was there. Justin Fels into the neutral zone. Over to Berkmeyer. Berkmeyer puts it in. Simon Selle's there by himself. Puts a big hit on in the corner. On to Michael Callahan. Sabatino with the hit. Keller with the puck. Simon Selle keeps it in. Riley just over. Joey Sabatino. Over to Dylan Thompson. Thompson unable to get it. Tim Rye with Justin Fels. Justin Fels comes out with it. Back to Spencer Turner. Spencer Turner, cross-ice pass to Dylan Thompson. Thompson clears, puts it in to back behind to Joey Sabatino. Tim Rye's with him. Dylan Thompson's back behind the net. And Sabatino over to the corner. Sabatino. Able to be cleared out. Big hit put on by Tim Rye. Tim Rye, not the biggest player, but he just put on a monster hit. Spencer Turner up to Jens Juliasson. Jens Juliasson's all by himself. He goes in, he skates. Oh, and just wide as the puck went over his stick. Juliasson back, shot, goal! Spencer Barlow picking up the rebound. Saints are up 4-2, and that's a hat trick for Spencer Barlow as hats are being thrown on to the ice. I say hats, let's go singular. A hat was thrown onto the ice. Number 29, Spencer Barlow with the natural hat trick. And Saints are up 4-2. Big hit center ice by Spencer Barlow. Spencer Barlow taken down, no call. Jens Juliasson in front of his own goal. He skates, he goes now back behind his own goal. Pass it over to Keller. Phil Kemmer plays it and is able to clear the zone back into the neutral zone. Billikens take possession into their zone, clear it out, neutral zone. Ryan Grilley and Phil Kemmer there. Kemmer kicks at it behind his goal all the way to the left side, and it's out of the zone. Alex Keller with speed. Puck cleared out, but Ryan Gridley is there. Gridley behind his own goal. Stops, puts it back to Phil Kemmer. Kemmer over to Troy Hafner. Hafner and Juliasson. Juliasson over the blue line. Cuts in front. Good defense. Travis Herrick into the zone. Justin Fels cuts in front of his neck. Steals the puck. Justin Fels by himself. He's got Troy Hafner. Puck kept in. Cleared out and then cleared back in. Troy Hafner by himself in the corner in the Billiken zone. He gets some help by Michael Lane. Michael Lane knocked off the puck. Puck still in the corner. Big hit put on by Alex Chiodini. Chiodini keeps it in. Pass to Troy Hafner, he's unable to get hands on it. Billikens cleared out. And the puck is cleared. Into the Billiken zone. No icing on the play. Alex Chiodini in the chase. Troy Hafner gets it to himself. Backhand over the goal. Billikens on the rush. Over the blue line, shot wide of Zadina. Ooh, and Michael Lane was almost able to touch it out of the zone. Justin Fels in behind Zadina. He takes a look, gets it to Michael Lane. Michael Lane over his own blue line. Alex Chiodini puts it into the zone, and they're going to go for a wholesale change. Billiken's able to get the puck into the neutral zone, over the red line, over the blue line. Shot, oh, just over the goal of Zadina. Another shot just wide. Michael Callahan's got it down low. Still got it and puts it into the zone. Johnny Verdu up to the right side. Good keep in and a tip. What a save. But Carson Zadina, as Billikens were able to get a shot and a tip on front. Berkmeyer goes behind the net, trips up a little bit. Johnny Verdu one-on-one. Keeps the guy outside. Shot saves Zadina. Riley just on the right side, loses the puck. Johnny Verdu behind his own goal. No one else there. Riley just on the chase. Nolan Meyer behind the goal. Takes a swat at Zadina. Puck cleared out. Riley just not there. No icing on the play. Matt Simoncelli on the chase. So is Spencer Turner. And put in by Dylan Thompson. Billikens able to clear it out. Icing on the play as Johnny Verdu goes back. 10-10 left in the second period. Shots are 17-15 in favor of the Billikens, but Maryville Saints are up 4-2 with the Spencer Barlow hat trick. Spencer Barlow playing physical, putting the puck in the back of the net just like they need him to do. Face off to the left of the Billikens goaltender as we wait for the fifth player to come out for Billikens. That is Nolan Meyer. Tim Rye to take the faceoff for Maryville, wins it back. Grau able to put it in. Tim Rye exits the zone so they stay onside. Kept in by Grau. Billikens offsides, put it into the zone. Phil Kemmer behind his own goal. Phil Kemmer sets it up. Passes over to Tim Rye. He's on the rush. Over to Dylan Thompson, clears it in. Dylan Thompson behind the net of Slew. And Slew comes out with it. Pass up to Michael Jonell. Stolen by Tim Rye. And Grau was able to put it back into the Billikens zone. Billikens cleared out of their zone, but Phil Kemmer's there. Phil Kemmer hassle, Slew gets it. Pass in front, good defense. High shot, high flutter shot over the head of Carson Zadina. The puck hits the net for a whistle. 9 minutes on the dot, folks, left in the second period. And like we talked about before, Maryville and Slew met each other last night, and Slew was able to come out with the win 4-2. And that's the score we got now in favor of Maryville. Faceoff one, Alex Keller up on the rush, pass to himself, no icing on the play, behind the goal, passes it in the middle. Spencer Barlow there looking for number four, but the puck's cleared out. Justin Feltz down in his own zone, looks for the man, is able to get one at Jens Juliusson just over his stick. Spencer Barlow into the rush. Takes his man. Alex Keller's there to get the puck. Keller below the goal line. Spencer Barlow. Spencer Barlow gets one that flutters in. The puck is covered on the play. We're going to get a faceoff in the Billikens zone. Jens Juliusson to take the faceoff. Spencer Barlow to his left. Alex Keller to his right. Face-off, Juliusson wins it. Back to Feltz. Feltz goes to put it in the zone, but gets taken away. What a move! Michael Callahan! What a save! What a save by Carson Zadina! Yes, Michael Callahan was in all alone. Callahan was able to make that jump, that toe drag. One-on-one, Carson Zadina, and Zadina sticks out that left leg with a beautiful save. Net was hit off the moorings, came off. There's a face-off to the left of Carson Zadina. He's going to take a second to fix his paraphernalia as a couple players fell on top of him after that big save. Once again, Jens Juliasen on the faceoff against Michael Callahan. Callahan wins the faceoff, but Maryville able to clear it. Keller over to Juliasen, over the blue line, goes wide, goes on the inside. Spencer Barlow puts it behind the goal. Alex Keller there pressuring. Billiken's able to clear it out through the neutral zone. Michael Callahan passes up. Good defense, Justin Feltz. Justin Feltz up to Jens Juliasen, catches it to himself, over the blue line, into the zone, kicks it, shot! Oh, just wide of the goal. Some little soccer work by Jens Juliasen. Billiken's able to clear the puck. Jeffrey Au into the zone, into the middle, shot! And blocked by Justin Feltz. Justin Feltz has Juliasen, but Spencer Turner grabs it into the zone, back to Jens Juliasen. Juliasen by himself on the near side boards. Puts it behind to Alex Keller. Alex Keller with Juliasen. And the Bill can just give a high hoister out of the zone. Johnny Verdu behind his own goal. Kind of an errant pass. He's looking for Alex Chiodini. No, no icing. As Michael Lane was there looking for Chiodini out front. Back behind the goal, Spencer Turner's there, puts a big hit on. Johnny Verder behind his own goal, over to Spencer Turner. Troy Hafner can't get it out and finally does. Puck cleared up, hits the net, hits the top of the glass, and we're going to get a whistle. 6:39 left in the second period. Shots are 18-17 in favor of the Billikens, 4-2 in favor of Maryville. Some great back and forth action. Both goalies showing up. Carson Sedina with the most recent big save. Faceoff won by Billikens, but it goes out of the zone. Riley just on the chase. He almost gets it. Simon Selle does, but he misplaces it. Phil Kemmer over to the side. Grabs it. Matt Birkmeyer there. Ooh, big hit. Over by the Billikens bench. Riley just is there. Riley just puts it on, save! Birkmeyer was right there, but the Billikens goaltender able to clear it up. So 6:16 left in the second period. 18-18 on shots. Like we said, 4-2 is a score. Simon Selle just takes a shot off the faceoff. Riley just is there. Simon Selle, Riley just good for it. Pass Birkemeyer. Birkemeyer gets in the neutral zone. Back into Maryville's zone. Oh, big move. Big save. Oh, and he's taken down. Billiken's able to get in, but Carson Zadina says no thank you and covers the puck. Phil Kemmer and Matt Simon Selle were there. And the score remains 4-2. Looks like Michael Callahan takes a faceoff for Slough, wins it back to the D. Shot on, save, Carson Zadina. And Saints are able to clear it back into the neutral zone. Billiken's back into Saint zone. Justin Feltz behind his goal. Over to Grau. Grau misplaces it. Shot on. Goal! Shot from the point. Carson Sedina did not see it. Beats him glove side and slew. Brings it within one. 5:27 left in the second period. 4-3 Maryville. Slew brings it within one goal. Back down to the Maryville zone. Jens Juliusson there. Shot on just wide of the goal. Justin Feltz able to get the puck. Luke Feltz, excuse me. Dylan Thompson able to clear it out. Keller's there. Juliusson to Keller. Keller over the blue line. Okay. Well, it is Max Gaudette in the goal, folks. Okay. I thought it was Zadina. It's Gaudette. It's Zadina. Max Gaudette's playing goal. Max Gaudette takes a tumble. I'm not sure what happened there. Jens Juliusson by himself. He's going to take on two defenders. Juliusson hit. Shot. Oh, just wide. Bilkins through the neutral zone. Spencer Turner's there. He takes this guy to the outside. Good hit, Spencer Turner. Gaudette hits it to the outside. Shot from the point. Just wide of the goal. Spencer Turner behind his own goal. Michael Lane's there. Troy Hafner on the side taking his man out, and Michael Lane goes to the point. We're going to go ahead and get a whistle on the play as the Maryville goal comes off its moorings. And like I said, folks, we have different numbers and different names and this and that. So we've been told with certainty that it is Max Gaudette in goal. Apologize for that. Face-off won by the Saints. Bilkins grab it into the corner. Good defense over by Spencer Turner. Turner gets it up to Troy Hafner. He's got his pocket picked. Slew gets it into the zone. Hafner there. Over to Lane, who's by himself. He tries to beat the defender. Good defense. Oh, and he goes into the Billikens goaltender, but no extracurricular activity tonight. .22 shots on goal for Billikens. They bring it within one. I know Coach Romerill knew it wasn't going to be an easy one. Win for Matt Simoncelli. They get it back. Oh, an errant pass over there by Phil Kemmer. Gridley's there. Kemmer is also there. Coming back to help out is Riley Just. Matt Berkmeyer on the far side through the neutral zone. And the ref's got his hand up in the air for a penalty. Let's see who gets it. Little explanation going over to head coach Romerill. As we get a whistle, 2:47 left in the second period. We'll see what happens here with this penalty call. Doesn't appear anybody from Maryville's going to the bench except for Alex Keller, number 77. So I take that back. Saints will go on the penalty kill as Keller takes a penalty. 2:47 left. Maryville up by 1-4-3. And the faceoff is to the left of Max Gaudette. Jens Juliusson out there, of course. Best penalty killer Maryville's D2 team has. Jens loses it. Back to the D. Bilkins play with it. Good D, Spencer Turner. He's able to clear it. Juliusson down on the chase. He's able to get his man. And Juliusson by himself. Spencer Barlow. Goal! shorthanded goal, Spencer Barlow, number 4 of the day. And the Saints are up 5-3. As the Billikens defender was trying to exit the zone, Spencer Barlow stole the puck and was able to put it in. A shorty for number 29, Spencer Barlow. More explanation over on the Maryville side. And Maryville's gonna get another penalty. Grouse going to the box. Not quite sure what happened. So the puck is in behind the Billikens goaltender. 5-3, Maryville Saints. Far pass. That goes behind Max Gaudette. Billikens able to grab it out. Bring it in, shot, save, Gaudette. Another shot on. Max Gaudette able to get it out of the air. Back to the point. They go for a shot, blocked out in front. And once again, the net on the far side. The Maryville Saints side right now comes off its moorings. So not sure if Grau got a, I don't know, an unsportsmanlike? We're not quite sure, but there's two Maryville Saints in the penalty box. 1:50 left in the second period. Spencer Barlow with 4 of 5 Maryville Saints goals. Face-off won by Maryville behind the goal. Spencer Turner gets it. The speedy Spencer Turner takes it himself through the neutral zone, over the blue line. Gets a shot, save. Back behind Billikens' goal. They break it out through the neutral zone. Johnny Verdu back to get it. And he clears the zone. Puck goes in behind the Billikens' goaltender as he plays it for his defender, Peter Rubis. Takes it himself up to the neutral zone. Jens Juliason over to Simon Selle. Shot, Simon Selle. Glove save, Billikens goaltender. Nice snap of the wrist by Matt Simon Selle, looking for his first goal of the evening. But Spencer Barlow's got a pocket full of goals. Share the wealth, Barlow, share the wealth. Through the neutral zone, Billikens into Maryville zone. That is Tarek Bag. Back to Michael Callahan at the point. Shot on, doesn't make it toward the net. And Jens Juliason's able to clear it out as he takes a big hit. Phil Kemmer clears the puck all the way down. Four and icing. As the Maryville Saints are now even strength. So there's 36 seconds left in the second period. 23-22 are the shots in favor of SLU. But Maryville's up 5-3. Thank you to Spencer Barlow. Jens Juliason to take the faceoff to the left of Max Gaudette, and he wins it. Feltz over, clears the zone. Spencer Barlow's there. Almost gets another break. Big hit Barlow into the defensive zone. Barlow's got it in the neutral zone, loses it. Callahan up, Spencer Barlow going with it. Spencer Barlow gets in a scrum in the defensive zone, no call on the play. 10 seconds left in the period. Berkmeyer's there behind the goal. Gets it to Barlow, 5 seconds. Barlow clears it in, and that's gonna do it. That is the end of the second period here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. We have Maryville and SLU. Maryville up 5-3. The shots are 23-22 in favor of the SLU Billikens, but like I said, it is 5-3 Maryville Saints. Third period coming up. We'll be right back here on the Maryville Saints Hockey Network.
wherever you live, from Bridgeton to Baldwin, Brentwood to Kirkwood, St. Anne to St. Charles, wherever you live. Hazelwood to Maplewood, the name you know, Frederick Roofing, wherever you go. For a hole in your roof or a whole new roof, Frederick Roofing.
St. Louis, 314-645-2000.
A lot of the times, students that are thinking about entering our program, they have a lot of questions. They've done their research. A lot of the questions that the students have are based upon outcomes. Where am I going to be 4 years from now if I decide to be in the Rawlings Sport Business Management Program? Here, I'll show you. Here's where our alumni work now. We have students working in the athletic department at universities. We have students working for sports teams. We have students working for sports agencies, whether it be an Abstract Marketing, a Learfield Sports, an IMG. Those are a lot of the organizations that are hiring our students. And we do have a lot of our alumni who do work for sports teams, whether it be the Houston Rockets, the Kansas City Royals, the St. Louis Cardinals, St. Louis Blues. Many of our students have worked for those agencies and continue to work for those types of organizations now.
Howie's Stretch Grip Tape is a self-adhering cushiony gauze for better grip at the end of your knob. It's spongy for maximized comfort and cushion on your gloves, and it's soft yet abrasive to ensure the best grip. Howie's Pro Grip Tape is self-adhering with no adhesive to create an all-around grip on your stick knob. It uses a thinner material than our Stretch Grip Tape to create a coarse abrasive tack on your gloves, and it's used around the globe by professionals.
I enjoy working with Lauren because she's really consistent. She follows up, she makes the process as quick as she can, and just really helps get you in, get you out, and make sure you know everything you need to. Hi, I'm Jessica, and I bought a 2021 Ford Edge for my company today from Lauren Sutter. So my company is expanding their sales force and needed to equip our new business managers with a vehicle. And we reached out to Lauren at Lou Fuse to get them with the right SUV. She helped us find the 2021 Ford Edge. I purchased my first one from her a couple months ago, and the process was so painless and easy that I'm back again for my second one. And we'll be back again probably in a couple months to buy another. I think somebody would come buy a vehicle from Lauren at Lou Fuse if they're looking for an easy process, somebody who is not going to guide them in the wrong direction and help them get exactly what they're looking for.
The day the world stopped was the day we found where to go. Lost together, we discovered ourselves again. And we realized that the things that matter deserve time. From now on, we're not going to leave anything on our plates. Because we've learned to savor the moments that were always there. We'll be right back. and they never tasted this good.
CCM One Piece boot.
The CCM One Piece boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid. Anyone could be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that One Piece boot, you duster.
St. Louis, 314-645-2000.
A lot of the times, students that are thinking about entering our program, they have a lot of questions. They've done their research. A lot of the questions that the students have are based upon outcomes. Where am I going to be 4 years from now if I decide to be in the Rawlings Sport Business Management Program? Here, I'll show you. Here's where our alumni work now. We have students working in the athletic department at universities. We have students working for sports teams. We have students working for sports agencies, whether it be an Abstract Marketing, a Learfield Sports, an IMG. Those are a lot of the organizations that are hiring our students. And we do have a lot of our alumni who do work for sports teams, whether it be the Houston Rockets, the Kansas City Royals, the St. Louis Cardinals, St. Louis Blues. Many of our students have worked for those agencies and continue to work for those types of organizations now.
Howie's Stretch Grip Tape is a self-adhering cushiony gauze for better grip at the end of your knob. It's spongy for maximized comfort and cushion on your gloves, and it's soft yet abrasive to ensure the best grip. Howie's Pro Grip Tape is self-adhering with no adhesive to create an all-around grip on your stick knob. It uses a thinner material than our Stretch Grip Tape to create a coarse abrasive tack on your gloves, and it's used around the globe by professionals.
I enjoy working with Lauren because she's really consistent. She follows up, she makes the process as quick as she can, and just really helps get you in, get you out, and make sure you know everything you need to. Hi, I'm Jessica, and I bought a 2021 Ford Edge for my company today from Lauren Sutter. So my company is expanding their sales force and needed to equip our new business managers with a vehicle. And we reached out to Lauren at Lou Fuse to get them with the right SUV. She helped us find the 2021 Ford Edge. I purchased my first one from her a couple months ago, and the process was so painless and easy that I'm back again for my second one. And we'll be back again probably in a couple months to buy another. I think somebody would come buy a vehicle from Lauren at Lou Fuse if they're looking for an easy process, somebody who is not going to guide them in the wrong direction and help them get exactly what they're looking for.
The day the world stopped was the day we found where to go. Lost together, we discovered ourselves again. And we realized that the things that matter deserve time.
Come on.
bag.
For two.
From now on, we're not going to leave anything on our plates. Because we've learned to savor the moments that were always there. And they never tasted this good.
CCM one-piece boot.
The CCM one-piece boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid. Anyone could be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that one-piece boot, you duster.
St. Louis, 314-645-2000.
A lot of the times, students that are thinking about entering our program, they have a lot of questions. They've done their research. A lot of the questions that the students have are based upon outcomes. Where am I going to be 4 years from now if I decide to be in the Rawlings Sport Business Management Program? Here, I'll show you. Here's where our alumni work now. We have students working in the athletic department at universities. We have students working for sports teams. We have students working for sports agencies, whether it be an Abstract Marketing, a Learfield Sports, an IMG. Those are a lot of the organizations that are hiring our students. And we do have a lot of our alumni who do work for sports teams, whether it be the Houston Rockets, the Kansas City Royals, the St. Louis Cardinals, St. Louis Blues. Many of our students have worked for those agencies and continue to work for those types of organizations now.
Howie's Stretch Grip Tape is a self-adhering cushiony gauze for better grip at the end of your knob. It's spongy for maximized comfort and cushion on your gloves, and it's soft yet abrasive to ensure the best grip. Howie's Pro Grip Tape is self-adhering with no adhesive to create an all-around grip on your stick knob. It uses a thinner material than our Stretch Grip Tape to create a coarse abrasive tack on your gloves, and it's used around the globe by professionals.
I enjoy working with Lauren because she's really consistent. She follows up, she makes the process as quick as she can, and just really helps get you in, get you out, and make sure you know everything you need to. Hi, I'm Jessica, and I bought a 2021 Ford Edge for my company today from Lauren Sutter. So my company is expanding their sales force and needed to equip our new business managers with a vehicle. And we reached out to Lauren at Lou Fuse to get them with the right SUV. She helped us find the 2021 Ford Edge. I purchased my first one from her a couple months ago, and the process was so painless and easy that I'm back again for my second one. And we'll be back again probably in a couple months to buy another. I think somebody would come buy a vehicle from Lauren at Lou Fuse if they're looking for an easy process, somebody who is not going to guide them in the wrong direction and help them get exactly what they're looking for.
The day the world stopped was the day we found where to go.
I'm not
Lost together, we discovered ourselves again. And we realized that the things that matter deserve time. From now on, we're not going to leave anything on our plates. Because we've learned to savor the moments that were always there. And they never tasted this good.
The CCM One Piece Boot.
The CCM One Piece Boot.
If I had these in my day,
I could have been Connor McDavid.
I could have been Connor McDavid.
Anyone could be Connor McDavid.
Helps make your feet faster, gives you a closer fit. Anyone can be Connor McDavid.
Looking sharp, bud. Good thing you got that one-piece boot, you duster.
Here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. Maryville Saints over the Slough Billikens 5-3 after two. 20 minutes of play left in the game. Shots are 23-22 in favor of the Slough Billikens. But like I just stated, Maryville Saints are up 5-3 in the score. Four goals on the day by Spencer Barlow of Maryville Saints. We'll see if he can add to that. And we're back in action. Jens Juliusson with the faceoff, loses it. Michael Lane grabs the puck, gets it out of his zone. Spencer Barlow, the man of the day, in. But knocked off the puck. Michael Lane behind the Billikens goal. Billikens able to clear it out. It's going to go the length of the ice for an icing as Thomas Vitt is able to go back and grab that puck. We talk about him. You never really hear him, but our producer Eric Skelton is going to join me for the third period here. As I've been by myself all game, so here we are. Michael Lane down with the puck. Jens Juliusson to Barlow. Shot gets blocked wide. Jens Juliusson back to Feltz. Feltz with the shot, another one blocked. Feltz gets it back out of the zone. Barlow back to Thomas Vitt. Vitt carries it, and Jens Juliusson chases it behind the goal. Saints forwards go for a change. Matt Berkmeyer over on the chase. Into the neutral zone. Verdu able to clear it. Berkmeyer into the Billikens zone. Verdu back in the neutral zone. Grabs it, clears it in on goal. As Slough's got a new goaltender in for the third period. Johnny Verdu with the shot just over the goal as Matt Berkmeyer was right there on the doorstep. Slough able to clear it, but Riley just gets it over to Berkmeyer into the Slough zone. Berkmeyer behind the goal. Takes his man out. Matt Simoncelli able to clear it in behind the goal. Berkmeyer there, Justice there. And it's a breakaway. Coming in, back check, Spencer Turner, goal! Spencer Turner was there, but Michael Jonell was able to get a breakaway. And Slew again brings it within one. 5-4, 18-10 left in the period.
Yeah, not a bad move by Spencer Turner trying to lift the stick on that breakaway. Unfortunately, he was just a couple inches off for it, and sadly that puck got put in the back of the net. And sadly, I have to talk whenever something bad happens.
That's all right, Eric. That's all right. Michael Lane up. Hafner up to get the puck. Put into Maryville zone. Max Gaudette out to play it. Plays it along the far side. Over to Hafner. Hafner behind his own goal. Back to Kemmer. Kemmer's over on the far side, or the near side. Able to clear it out is Chiodini. Michael Lane over to Hafner. Hafner back to Michael Lane. Knocked off the puck. Chiodini down far. Back to the point to Kemmer. Shot block in front. Into the neutral zone, but Kemmer gets it back. Back down behind the Billikens goal. The Saints are offsides, have to tag up. Billikens have a 3-on-1 as they break up. Good defense by number 11, Ryan Gridley. Saints able to clear it out into the neutral zone. Billikens take control up to the Saints blue line. They enter the zone. Good defense, Gridley again. And Joey Sabatino on the rush. Tim Rye able to keep it in. Joey Sabatino down low. Puck goes behind the Billikens goal. And they clear it out. All the way down the ice. No icing. Big hit over on Dylan Thompson. Feltz is there. Sabatino. Feltz takes control. Over the red line. Over the blue line. Over to Sabatino. Unable to get a handle on it. Billikens able to clear the zone, down to the neutral zone, but Tim Rye's there. Falls down. Sabatino in the Billikens zone, just past him. Into the neutral zone, back down into Maryville zone. Luke Feltz is there, and that's an icing. For some reason, I keep wanting to call him Justin Feltz. It sounds right to me, but you know what? It's not right. It's Luke Feltz.
It's like earlier when I was calling Justin Turner, Spencer Turner, Justin Turner. I had baseball in my mind.
I mean, we got Justin. Someone needs to be called Justin. Justin's on our mind. So we got Jens Juliusson to take the faceoff. He loses it. Billikens take control, clear it up to the neutral zone. Verdu there. Verdu over to Lane. Lane clears it all the way down. Jens Juliusson behind the Billikens goal. Barlow there to keep it in. Oh, big hit Barlow. He was the recipient but stood tall. Knocked his man down.
And that's a few times now that we've seen Barlow have a big hit on these Slew players tonight. Even though he's not the biggest guy, he can scrap it up out there with the best of them.
He sure can. Spencer Turner into the neutral zone. Has his partner but doesn't go to him. Goes to Michael Lane. Billikens get it back into Maryville zone. Spencer Turner's there. Clears it out to Jens Juliusson. Juliusson, rink-wide pass to Michael Lane. Michael Lane on the near side. Barlow coming over with the hit. Verdu unable to clear it in. Phil Kemmer up behind his goal line. Clears it back. Johnny Verdu able to grab the puck, clear it down the far side. Not out. Billikens keep it in behind. Phil Kemmer takes out his man. Michael Lane's there as well. Jens Juliusson grabs the puck. Juliusson gets his pocket picked over to Johnny Verdu. Verdu to Juliusson. Juliusson by himself. 5-on-1. Shot just over the goal. Jens Juliusson in all by himself. Phil Kemmer gets it in the neutral zone over to Gridley. Gridley's in. Riley just grabs the puck by himself. Berkmeyer's there. Kemmer's there. Kemmer puts it down into the zone. Just grabs it. Gets a shot. And that's a save. That looked like it went in. A crazy shot from the side by number two, Riley Just. But the goaltender able to snag it up. There'll be a faceoff to the left of the Billikens goaltender.
And we've seen goals like this in the past. Well, goals that could have been like that in the past. Bad angle shots, bounce off the goalie, you never know. That one did fool us a little bit, though.
Sure did. It looked like it went in as Billikens just iced the puck. And we're going to get another faceoff down in the Billikens zone. We got Matt Simoncelli, Berkmeyer, Feltz, Riley Just out there, and Thomas Vitt. We'll see if Matt Simoncelli can win this one back. Over to the side, Berkmeyer goes to grab it. Out of the zone, over the red line, into Maryville's zone behind the net. Thomas Vitt is there. His man takes him out. Feltz is there as well. Berkmeyer up, that gets out of the zone, and Slew is offside, just barely out of the zone. We're going to have a faceoff here in the neutral zone, close to the near boards. Simoncelli line stays out there. 13:49 left in the period. Faceoff won by Matt Simoncelli. Back to Thomas Vitt, to Riley Just, hitting in the neutral zone. Riley Just takes out his man. Feltz to grab the puck. Over to Berkmeyer. Berkmeyer clears it out, and that's going to be an icing. So faceoff's going to go back into the Maryville zone.
Yeah, Just did a good job there trying to get that puck away from his man on the offensive side. Unfortunately, it was an icing. I saw it clip, but we can't be biased.
Not much they could do about that one. Face off to the left of Max Gaudette. One by Billikens. Shot on, blocked in front by Feltz. Tall Feltz. Matt Simoncelli on the far side, muscles his man off. Shot blocked. Matt Simoncelli, big hit on the near side. Feltz takes his man out in the corner. Tries to clear, but it's kept in by Billikens. Get a shot on. Saved by Max Gaudette into the net. We're going to have a faceoff here to the right of the Maryville goaltender, Max Gaudette.
I like the way Feltz has been putting his body in front of the net, or in front of the puck. That's what Maryville's built off of. We talked about it on D1 broadcast. You guys have talked about it on D2 and even on the women's broadcast. That's what Maryville prides themselves on, is blocking shots, not letting the goaltender see too many of those. And that's just another case for Feltz tonight, as I just saw him block two in a row.
Absolutely. As he's a big body. So back down into the Billikens zone, we're going to get a penalty on Hafner as he took out his man. Ref didn't like that one, so Troy Hafner with Maryville is going to go to the penalty box. Four cross-check. So with a 5-4 game, 12:49 left in the period, 25 shots apiece. One-goal game, this is a great chance for the Billikens to tie it up.
The Billikens have had a few times this game where earlier in the game they had a 5-on-4. A couple times in the second period you saw them on the power play. They've had numerous chances, and Maryville stepped up. This is just another chance for the Saints to step up and shut them down again.
So the puck on the near side, one back to the point. The points play catch. Near side, shot, goes behind the goal. Jens Juliusson on the far side, takes out his man, big hit. Spencer Turner's there. Puck pass back to the Billikens defender, gets a shot on, blocked in front into the corner. Peter Rubis is there. Passes it back. Right back to him. Gets a shot on goal. Save Max Gaudette. Jens Juliusson on the far side. Defenders play catch. Shot blocked again. Oh, just wide of the goal. Billikens have it. Near side. Shot. Save. Yeah, there we go. A little bit of action up front as Max Gaudette saves the puck. He gets a stick to the midsection, and he doesn't take too kindly of it. Taking down number 24 in front, and it looks like the Billikens are going to go to the box for that slash on Max Gaudette. And that absolutely, the ref calls him for a slap. So it's going to be 4-on-4 play for a minute 3. Faceoff goes all the way down into the Billiken zone. Matt Simoncelli, Michael Lane, Phil Kemmer, and Luke Feltz out there for Maryville Saints. Wish I could tell you who's out there for SLU, but all the numbers are on, Eric.
I tried looking the first two periods. Can't find anything.
So Luke Feltz down. Max Gaudette able to play the puck. Michael Lane's there here on the near side. Feltz up behind his net. Clears it, hits a stancher, goes weird bounce. Shot on, set aside by Max Gaudette. Billigans keep it in at the point. They play catch. They get a shot blocked by Feltz. Near side, Matt Simoncelli takes out his man. Shot, save. Blocked by Phil Kemmer, actually. Feltz on the near side, gets his pocket picked. Backhander, good save, Max Gaudette. And Matt Simoncelli just says no thank you as he took out his man and swiped a stick. He said, get out of here, bud.
Definitely no bad blood loss between these two teams. Last time I saw them play was my first season here with MSHN. We saw them a couple years ago. They were very physical, both games. It seems to be boiling over a little bit, but not as much as I anticipated there to be with that rivalry between these two teams.
Yeah, two local teams, you know there's going to be some bad blood. So Saints win the faceoff. Verdue over to Spencer Turner. Turner over to Barlow. Billikens get it in front, pass it just wide. Billikens have it down low. We're on 4-on-4 play here, folks. Spencer Turner. Jens Juliason grabs the puck. Jens Juliason, Spencer Barlow. Turner back on the play with them. Maryville's going to have a 53-second power play. Matt Simoncelli on the back end. Goes to the neutral zone. Looking for a man. Just puts it in the zone. Why not? On goal. And the Billikens goalie just catches it and doesn't let go of it. Good play by Matt Simoncelli is now they're going to get a faceoff set up in the Billiken zone.
That was another good penalty kill by the Saints there. That's what they've been doing all season. We've seen it time and time again. I know that's one thing that Coach Aaron Romerl prides himself on is his special teams play during these games.
Absolutely. Puck squeaks back to Spencer Turner, to Jens Juliason. Spencer Turner, shot just wide of the goal. Billikens grab it behind their goal. They're going to clear it just to the right of Max Gaudette. Spencer Turner back to grab it. Sets up a play. He's got Matt Simoncelli to his right, but Spencer Turner takes it for himself. Through the neutral zone, red line, blue line, still in, gets a shot just wide. Jens Juliason grabs the rebound on the near side here. Puts it behind the goal. Jens Juliason keeps the puck, and we're going to get a penalty. Looks like Alex Chiodini, and he's going to get a misconduct as well. He had a few choice words for the referee, it looked like. He was going to get a two-minute penalty. He skated by, spoke his mind, and it seems like they're going to give him, yep. Now the referee is sending him to the shower, so Chiodini's done for the evening. As he was speaking his mind, as I can feel for him because, well, when I play, I don't keep my mouth shut, so I don't blame him.
And that's unfortunate, you know, with 10 minutes on the clock left, it's a 5-4 game.
Yeah.
You can't put your team in that position.
You don't, yeah.
You gotta keep your composure, keep the momentum going, keep pushing forward. Don't let this SLU team get inside of your head.
Right. Yeah, especially in a one-goal game, you're absolutely correct. Under 10 minutes, so it's do or die time here. In 5 seconds, Saints are going to go on the penalty kill. Puck on the near side, back to the Billikens point. Back behind Gaudette, into the front. No one's there for it. Jens Juliason racing down. As the puck's behind the goal, played it to the near side. Spencer Barlow's there to grab it. Clears it in, Barlow and Juliason in deep on this penalty kill. Through the neutral zone for the Billikens. Red line into the Saints zone. Blue line. Back to the point. In deep, Jens Juliason's there to intercept it. Turns around and gets a clear. 1:15 left in the Billikens power play. 9:10 left in the game. Billikens set up from their zone. They get into the neutral zone. Clear it into Maryville Saints territory. Shot, save, Max Gaudette. It's loose. And they're still poking at it. You can hear the ref's whistle. 1, 2, 3. And Max Gaudette seems to be a little bit shaken up. As all four Billikens right there on top of him.
And great job keeping that puck under control. Great job for Maryville coming in to help him out in front of that net. Keep that trash out of the back of it.
Yep.
Just awesome play all around defensively. Could be a little bit cleaner, but at least the puck didn't go in the back to tie up that game.
So 56 seconds left on the power play. 5-4 game in favor of Maryville. And the referee is kicking out these fans. I'm not sure what, you know, they got SLU shirts on. So the referee is kicking them out.
Yeah, they were getting pretty rowdy when I was in the restroom during the intermission break.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
All right, back to hockey play. Billikens win the faceoff. Gets a shot on, tip, save, Max Gaudette, rebound, save, ball is in up front, net, Simon Selle clears it.
Great job on Simon Selle.
Still in the zone, in the far corner, Matt Simon Selle's there again, tries to clear it, can't, to the point, they play catch, shot on, save, Max Gaudette. Simon Selle goes to clear, oh, and he does, okay, the puck cleared out. And that was actually Johnny Verdu that was able to clear it. Matt Simon Selle's having words with the Billikens on the other side.
He remembers that game 2 years ago.
I'm sure.
But great job on the Saints. Get that puck out of the zone. Give Max Gaudette a little breather there.
So Saints lose a faceoff. Max Gaudette gets it behind the goal. Johnny Verdu's able to clear it, just not out. Shot on, blocked by Johnny Verdu. Save, Max Gaudette, what a save. Spencer Turner looks to clear it, can't. Spencer Barlow's there, far side. Billikens get it, shot from the point. Save, Max Gaudette. Johnny Verdi behind the goal, 5 seconds left in the power play. In front, Jens Juliason is there. Maryville's even, shot from the point, blocked by Johnny Verdi again. Up in the air to Jens Juliason. Jens gets it, over to Rye. Oh, Jens behind the goal line. Loses it, back to Phil Kemmer. Phil Kemmer keeps it in the zone. Careens around, 76, grabs it. That's Dylan Thompson, over to Rye. It's in the corner, Thompson and Rye are there. And Billikens cleared out. Phil Kemmer back into his zone as the puck's cleared into it. And back into the Billikens zone. Sabatino goes for the chase behind the goal. Dylan Thompson there, misses the puck. Gridley, Rye. 7 minutes left in the game. Phil Kemmer behind his goal. Passes it over to Joey Sabatino, intercepted. Tim Rye there with the hit. Phil Kemmer in the corner to help him out. Billikens come out with it. Good defense, Joey Sabatino. Shot on, save, Max Gaudette with the right leg. Phil Kemmer clears out of the zone. Sabatino there all by himself. Gridley in his own zone. To Riley Just. Riley Just and Joey Sabatino by himself. Sabatino hit off the puck. Billikens intercept. There into the Maryville zone. Feltz takes his man, Gridley. Gets the puck. Sabatino hit on the far side. Gridley grabs it. Gridley over to Riley Just. Riley Just through the neutral zone. Puts it into Billikens zone. And they're able to clear it out. Two Saints fall over one another. Into the zone. Good block by Feltz. And the puck goes up into the netting. With 6:01 left in the game. Saints are up 5-4. But the Billikens are up 32-26 on shots.
And you got to give credit to where it's due with this SLU team. They've been putting the pressure on the Saints all night, especially during this third period with as many penalties as the Saints have taken.
Yep.
Fortunately for the Saints, they've been able to kill these penalties, but SLU's still putting on that pressure.
They sure are. They're not going to be able to take it easy. Feltz behind his own goal. Clears it out to Berkmeyer. Berkmeyer's down by himself. Riley Just is going to be coming in with him. And it sneaks out of the zone. Neutral zone. Jeffrey Au up into Maryville zone. Feltz is there, as he has been all game, behind the goal. Matt Berkmeyer on the near side, unable to get it out. But Matt Simoncelli is able to get it out. And we're going to have a penalty. It's going to be a rough on number two, Riley Just. So with 5:30 left in this game, Riley Just is going to go to the penalty box and put the Saints shorthanded once again.
This is not a spot that Coach Romero wants to be in with his team right now, especially with the way SLU's been putting on that pressure.
Right.
As he's going to call a timeout right now, but got to collect your thoughts, slow it down, slow your game down, play your game.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you don't want to be, especially, you know, yeah, you're up in the game, but you're still facing more shots. They've got six more shots on, and the faceoff's going to be down in their zone. So the last thing you want to do is go shorthanded. Hopefully they can kill it off.
It's like they say, the two-goal lead is always the hardest lead to keep. It's always the scariest one to keep as well. Like, Maryville needs to come out, stay strong, keep doing what they do on the PK.
Yep.
And just take it to SLU right now. That same aspect, if SLU wants to keep in this game, they got to put that pressure on Max Gaudet, test this defense right now as it's been tested this evening.
Yeah, and you got to believe that they are. They've been putting the shots on, as we see, six more than Maryville. So a two-minute power play for the Billikens. 5:30 left in the game. Maryville up 5-4. Great chance for the SLU Billikens to tie the game late here in the third period. Faceoff won by Jens Juliason. SLU comes out with it, though. Near corner, up to the point, back to the near side. Shot on. Ooh, glove save. Flashing that leather is Max Gaudet, the goaltender for the Maryville Saints.
That was an awesome save as that puck went between the legs of the SLU defender. And still yet, Max Gaudet was able to track that straight into his mitt.
So Jens Juliason on the faceoff loses it. Back to the Billikens point. Slap shot blocked by Spencer Barlow, excuse me. But SLU still gets it. Keeps it down low on the near side to the far side. Michael Lane was there. Spencer Turner. Too many Spencers here, guys. And Spencer Barlow is able to clear it.
As he almost takes out the linesman there.
Yeah. So down in their own zone, through the neutral zone, and into Maryville zone. Feltz is there, takes his man, ties him up, and an errant pass by the Billikens forward to their defender who wasn't there on the point. 50 seconds to go on the power play, 4:20 left in the game. Through the neutral zone. Goes between his legs, what a move, and there's a goal! Michael Callahan is able to tie the game with 4:11 left.
That's a tough one for Max, for Gaudet too, as that just flies right up in that little corner over his right shoulder. Well-placed shot by SLU. Ties it up.
Callahan was able to break in this near side and beat Max Gaudet to the short side. So we have a ball game here, folks. 4 minutes left in the game. And the ref whistles down a high stick. SLU fans here in the Maryville University Hockey Center are on their feet for that goal, and they're chanting, "Let's go, SLU." So 5-5, 4:05 left to go. Spencer Barlow down. And Billiken's able to clear. Billiken's into the Maryville zone. Spencer Barlow down for the back check. Good hit by Johnny Verdu. Spencer Turner. And there's going to be a penalty. A slashing penalty on Maryville with 3:43 left in the game.
That's a rough one to take. You got to be careful with how you handle your stick in these situations. You may not try to slash them, but with this close of a game tied up, 4 minutes left, you got to kind of keep your P's and Q's about you a little bit.
You do. And Spencer Barlow's had a great game tonight. He's got 4 of 5 goals for Maryville, but he takes that late penalty. So Billikens win the faceoff. Here to the near side, they've got a 2-minute power play. Shot on just wide of Max Gaudette. Kept in by Slew, put behind the net. Phil Kemmer's there by himself, taking on two men. Feltz is... Good save, Max Gaudette, and it's loose! It's loose! It sneaks out, shot, block, shot, and a save by Max Gaudette.
Amazing save by Max Gaudette. Awesome job on the Maryville defense to block that shot, even though there was a second attempt chance. Still, great job all around to keep the body in front of the puck.
The puck snuck out, and they're able to get a couple shots. Max Gaudette there is there to shut the door. Face off to the left of Max Gaudette. Slew wins it back to the point behind the goal. Feltz is there in the near corner with his man. Back to the point. They keep it in the near side behind the goal. In middle, Phil Kemmer's there, clears it. 3 minutes on the dot to go, 1:18 left in the power play. 34 shots for Slew, 26 for Maryville. Through the neutral zone, got a 3-on-2 for Slew. Far side, near side, puck goes behind the goal. Defense by Spencer Turner. Johnny Verdi was there, clears it into the neutral zone. Slew gets it to the neutral zone, they tag up. Spencer Turner's there. Spencer Turner clears the puck all the way down, looking for Jens Juliason. Billiken's back into the Maryville zone. Shot on, save, Max Gaudette. Puck's behind the goal.
So,
and that's a goal. Michael Callahan strikes again. 6-5, Billikens, 2 minutes and 15 seconds left in the game. And with 32 seconds left of the power play, Billikens take the lead. And Eric, that's exactly what we talk about taking penalties, especially late in the game. Keep your composure and play hockey. You can tell when that puck went in, Aaron Romerl just looked to the ceiling because he's thinking, guys, come on.
Couple out-of-place defensemen, couple out-of-place passes. Errant passes leads to the goal.
Yep.
Unfortunately, time for the Saints to buckle down. Slew's got to keep that pressure, though, if they want to keep up with this game. Like I said, hockey's crazy.
Hockey is crazy, and you know Maryville's not going to give up. I mean, they're down by one. That one shot, that one puck, that one tip can go in. So you got to think they're going to put the Juliason line out here, which they are. Jens Juliason, Spencer Barlow, Alex Keller, Johnny Verdu, and Spencer Turner out there for Maryville.
I kind of like to call this line the speed racer line. They're pretty quick.
They are quick. So 2:15, a lot of hockey to play. Slew takes the lead 6-5 on the power play. Faceoff won by the Billikens, back into their zone. Cleared up, Spencer Turner in his zone. Jens Juliason tips it down. Alex Keller there is unable to get it. Spencer Turner in his zone over to Johnny Verdu. Verdu passes over to Keller. Keller unable to get it back to Spencer Turner. Turner, Johnny Verdu, over to Spencer Barlow into the zone. Jens Juliason on the chase as the puck goes to the near side, or far side. Max Gaudette to the bench. 6 attackers on for Maryville. Shot just wide. That's going to be an icing. So the Billikens saw that Max Gaudette went to the bench and tried for that goal. Not sure if Michael Lane got a tip on it, but he was there. So now we have Jens Juliusson, Spencer Barlow, Alex Keller, Spencer Turner, Michael Lane, and Johnny Verdu, all six guys out there from Maryville. 1:41 left, faceoff one. Johnny Verdu keeps it in. Slew player falls down, gets on the puck, cleared out, and
hand pass.
A hand pass. So it's going to be another faceoff in the slew zone. Jens Juliusson to take the faceoff. Same men out there. Jens goes forward with it. He has it behind the goal. Michael Lane's there. Spencer Turner keeps the puck in. Shot on. Wide. Spencer Turner there. Shot on. Save. Faceoff's going to go to the left of the Billikens goalie. Same guys out there for Maryville. So all you got to do is keep the shots on. Shots. Hope for a rebound, hope for that first one to go in. So Spencer Barlow takes the faceoff, loses it. Billikens clear it. That should be another icing, and it is. Spencer Turner down there for the puck. It's gonna be another icing. So another offensive zone faceoff for Maryville. And you can't really do that when you're the Billikens. You can't be icing it like that. But that might be all they can do. So Jens Juliusson's going to take the faceoff. Wants to go forward with it. Comes back. Johnny Verdu's there. Keeps it in. Gets a shot. Blocked. Michael Lane able to keep it in the far corner. Puts it in the middle. No one there. Shot. Save. Goal! Maryville sinks. Tie the game with 59.8 seconds left. Number 77, Alex Keller, picks up the rebound, and it's a 6-6 game with 1 minute at the Maryville University Hockey Center.
What an excellent job by Keller there to keep with the puck, not letting it get too far out in front of the goalie, and just putting in that five hole and getting to the back of the net.
So they keep that Jens Juliusson line out there. 59.8 seconds to go. We have a 6-6 game. Maryville and SLU. What a barn burner here tonight, Eric.
Absolutely. Just goes back to what we said a few minutes ago. Anything can happen. You got to keep the pressure on both sides.
Jens Juliusson wins the faceoff. Feltz over to the far side. Into the Maryville zone. Spencer Barlow. Barlow to Keller. Keller to Juliusson. Keller grabs it, puts it down. Jens Juliusson's there. Keller keeps it in. Juliusson grabs the puck in the zone. Good defense. Billikens able to clear the zone into the neutral zone. 35 seconds to go. Pass in. Feltz is there. Feltz grabs it back to Kemmer. Kemmer to Keller. Keller tips it into the... they called it an icing. It looked to me as if Keller was past that red line when he tipped it in, but they're going to go ahead and call it icing. So the puck comes back to the right of Max Gaudette. 22.4 seconds to go in the game. 6-6 is the score with Alex Keller tying the goal. Tying the game. One by Billikin, shot on, blocked. To the point, another shot on, caught by Max Gaudette. Faceoff's going to be to the left of Max Gaudette. Forward line change. We got Simon Selle, Riley Just, and Matt Berkmeyer comes out there. 15.1 seconds. Simon Selle to take the draw. He wins it. Billikens get it behind the goal. They put it in front, wide. 8 seconds. Cleared out. 5. Riley Just takes a fall. Into the zone, and that's zeros on the clock. So we have a 6-6 game. We're going into overtime. Shots are 36-30 in favor of the Billikens. They're gonna take just a few minutes. They're gonna put out their power lines, and we have some overtime play, some extra play here at the Maryville University Hockey Center.
This is pretty exciting for me, being my first time on the call for any of the games. This was originally supposed to be my job before I took over the producer spot.
Yeah.
Let's go 3-on-3. Let's do that hockey.
This is, I know Todd Panula, who's usually here, he doesn't like the 3-on-3.
He does
not.
I love it.
The ice opens up. There's so much area for play. You never know what's going to happen. It's always back and forth. So the goalies switch sides. Jens Juliasson, Michael Lane, and Johnny Verdu. Do we have 4-on-3? We have 4-on-4. So Juliasson, Verdu, Spencer Turner, and Michael Lane out there for Maryville. And here we go. Overtime, faceoff won by Jens Juliasson. Verdu is back into his own zone, puts it up, and there's going to be an icing on the play. So the puck is going to go down to the Maryville zone. 4:52 left, just starting in overtime. Jens Juliasson in to take the faceoff to the right of Max Gaudette. Juliasson wins it. Back to Johnny Verdu. Verdu gets it here to the near side. Billiken's able to keep it in. Far side. Oh, and the guy was wide open. Max Gaudette caught one there. Jens Juliasson grabs the puck behind the net. He's got speed. He's on the near side in the neutral zone through the red line, over the blue line. He still has it. Michael Lane behind the net to Jens Juliasson. Goes for the pass in front, no one there. Billiken's grabbed the puck through the neutral zone over the red line. Spencer Turner's there. Oh, he gets beat. Shot, save Max Gaudette. Billiken still have it behind the goal. Jens Juliasson is there. He clears it out. Jens Juliasson clears it out for another icing almost. No icing on the play. Maryville goes for a change. Alex Keller comes out through the neutral zone into Maryville's zone. Near side here, Johnny Verdu's there. Spencer Barlow on the far side. Feltz behind the goal with his man. Johnny Verdu grabs the puck behind the goal, skates through the near side. He takes it himself through the neutral zone, gets knocked off the puck. Back in Maryville's zone, Feltz behind his own goal. He's pressured. And he plays it back for Johnny Verdu. Johnny Verdu behind Max Gaudette. Stops, gets caught in the ref skates. And he takes it himself. Now Spencer Barlow grabs it through the neutral zone. Barlow over the blue line by himself. To the far side, fans on his shot. Alex Keller's there, puts behind the goal. Spencer Barlow pressures. Slew clears it out. Phil Kemmer's there, takes the fall at the red line. Spencer Barlow's there, puts it into Billiken's zone. Wholesale change for Maryville. Through the neutral zone. Into the Maryville zone. Phil Kemmer is there with Matt Berkmeyer. Feltz is there. Feltz gets the puck. He's got himself on the far side. Over his blue line through the neutral zone. Into the zone. Feltz keeps it himself. He goes up. Oh, good defense by Billiken as they grab it now through the neutral zone. Phil Kemmer's there. They come in. He's shot. Save Max Gaudette. 2:20 to go in overtime. Matt Berkmeyer and Matt Simon Selly are there. Simon Selly's able to get it out. Oh, Berkmeyer's there. They don't able to get it out. Put back in towards Max Gaudette. Berkmeyer in his own zone to Simon Selly. Puck tipped. Simon Selly down into the far corner. Puck careens around. Johnny Verdu's there. Simon Selly behind the goal. Pass it in front. No one's there. Berkmeyer grabs the puck. Back to Spencer Turner. Turner with a shot. Easy save for the Billiken's goaltender as no one was there. 1:48 left to go in overtime. Shots are 38-33 in favor of SLU. And now we have Jens Juliasson, Riley Just, Johnny Verdu, and Spencer Turner.
Great efforts on both teams. Both teams having couple chances to score there, but both goaltenders saying not today.
Right. We got a timeout, so the teams are going to go to their respective benches. Nothing like some extra hockey on a Saturday night at the Maryville University Hockey Center. D1 was able to sweep Illinois State this weekend. And Maryville looking to take one of two for the D2 level. A slew won last night 4-2.
Yeah, Coach Romero would like to have this split this weekend, help him out in the standings as the Saints sit number 8 in the country this in their prospective rankings for D2 ACHA.
So Jens Juliusson, Spencer Turner, Riley Just, Johnny Verdu. Jens wins the faceoff to Riley Just. Just out of the reach of Jens. Slew able to clear it out. Johnny Verdu's there. He's pressured. Spencer Turner behind his own goal. The speedy Spencer Turner takes it himself on the near side, over the red line, into the zone, on his backhand, gets a shot that goes just wide. Johnny Verdu's there, keeps it in, over to Jens Juliusson. Jens Juliusson at the goal line, feeds it in front, no one there. Johnny Verdu clears it in, back to Jens Juliusson. Juliusson loses it, then keeps it. He was going for Riley Just, it just did not make it to him. Bilkins into the zone. Jens grabs it. Here we go, 2-on-1. Johnny Verdu and Riley Just over the blue line into the zone. Shot! Oh, just wide. As Johnny Verdu takes a big slap shot back into the Maryville zone. Jens Juliusson's there by himself. He gets held a bit, no call. In the corner, Jens by himself. Feltz is there, loses it. Behind the goal, in the front, Jens Juliusson, here we go. 3-on-1, over the red line to Riley Just. Back to Jens Juliusson, shot! Oh, it's a save. 24 seconds to go into the neutral zone. Feltz has the puck, Maryville tags, and they just clear it in. Feltz is there by himself. 15 seconds to go. Phil Kemmer behind his own goal. Fakes comes around. 5 seconds, Phil still got it. Gets it up to Spencer Barlow. Barlow over the red line, and he just clears it in the zone, and we are through overtime. So after 4 periods, folks, we are still at 6-6. 38 shots for Slew, 34 shots for Maryville. Talk about extra hockey. We're now going to go to a shootout. We're going to see which team comes out victorious.
I feel like I'm getting treated tonight during this game.
It's quite a treat for all of us. So thanks for hanging in there with us, folks. Like I said, we're given a couple different rosters this evening. Different names, different numbers. So we apologize, but thanks for sticking with us. So Slew is going to shoot first. On my sheet, number 9 is Joey Grigluski. Let's see if that is correct, but he's going to be the first shooter. So here we go, first shooter in. Over the blue line, in on Max Gaudette. Comes on, move, shot, save, Max Gaudette. Backhand, forehand, and Max Gaudette was there with the save. First shooter for Maryville, no surprise. Number 27, Jens Juliusson. And the whistle is blown. Jens Juliusson grabs a puck at the center. Over the blue line, Jens comes in slow. He's going to shot. Oh, what a save. Juliusson trying to get the goalie to bite. Go five hole. He was unable to do that. So it remains scoreless in the shootout.
Great job on the Slew goaltender shutting down that five hole on Jens Juliusson. Great job getting that blocker down on the Slew shooter that last round from Max Gaudette.
Oh, Slew guy almost falls. Shot, goal. So the Slew player, he's given a celebration, although he almost fell. He was able to get it past Max Gaudette. Number 5, Michael Lane for Maryville in over the blue line. Lane in, save. So Michael Lane unable to get a goal. Max Gaudette must save this for Maryville for them to continue. So here we go. The Billiken in over the blue line. He comes in back and forth on Gaudette. Shot, goal. And in shootouts, the SLU Billikens take the win and they take the sweep over the Maryville Saints. While Maryville still earned a point, the SLU Billikens were able to earn two. 7-6 is your final here at the Maryville University Hockey Center. Shots 38-34 in favor of SLU. And the teams are gonna line up, they're gonna shake hands after their meeting this weekend. And SLU takes it. A back and forth game, we had an overtime, and it got sent to shootouts, and that's how SLU takes the game, is in shootouts.
Tough one for the Saints to take tonight. In the end, it's like we talked about, you can't have those penalties. Yep. SLU capitalized on those penalties that Maryville had. Good on them. Congratulations to SLU. Well fought. They pushed it to the max.
They did.
They gave the Saints everything they had, and it showed out for them this weekend.
No doubt about that. SLU never gave up. Their fans are loving it. And that's it. 7-6, SLU Billikens over the Maryville Saints. Shots 38-34. I'm Chuck Kraus. For Eric Skelton, Maryville Saints Hockey Network, live here from the Maryville University Hockey Center. We'll see you on the next one. One last time, SLU takes an in shootout 7-6 over the Saints. Thank you for watching, and have a good night.